would like to welcome you all to our 9th annual Mother's Banquet. It's such a gift and blessing that you are here with us today, and we just thank you with all our hearts for your support and your love and your prayers of our program. And we have lots of people to thank today. I especially want to thank Seal Donahue and also Christina Berger and all the volunteers who really worked so hard to put this beautiful event together. They organized everything. They've been cooking for the last 2 days, and they've just done an awesome, awesome job. So I just wanted to give them a round of applause and thank them for everything that they've done. And all the volunteers who I didn't mention, I truly want to thank you for your help. And in a special way, I want to thank Father Tony DeMarco for all he's done for St. Gerard's. He is on our board, and he is definitely our spiritual leader, so we thank God for him. We also are so pleased to have, as you know, Dr. Nadal, who is our speaker. And what you may not know is that he is also one of our board of directors. Our board of directors are here today. We have Dr. Nadal. We also have Dr. Judy Mascolo. I know where Dr. Judy is. Dr. Judy also is the head and the director of our medical services, where we do the ultrasound services on Maple Avenue. We also have another board of director here. His name is David Borchetta. He's also going to be my future husband in August. And last but not certainly least, we have Robert Dean. He's also one of our board of directors. And Bob Dean has been with us ever since the program has begun. He organizes and does all the financial work for St. Gerard's, all the data processing, all the financial data. So he's an awesome volunteer. He works 6 days out of 7 days a week to help at St. Gerard's. He does it all for free, so praise God for him. Day after day, we pray in front of the Hartford GYN abortion mill, and we truly witness the immensity of that evil. The gravity of the sin of abortion was definitely revealed through the Gosnell trial, which I'm sure you're all aware of, and also the most recent Cleveland, Ohio case, whereby the truth of abortion was exposed to the public. And it highlights exactly what Jesus had said to us, which in the scriptures, Luke chapter 8, verse 17, Jesus said, "For nothing is hidden, but it will be made clear. Nothing secret, but it will be made known and brought to light." And despite all this evil, we are strengthened by faith. As Father Bavone so eloquently says, that we work from victory, and we are definitely putting our faith into action. And this is exactly what we've been doing at St. Gerard's for the last 9 years. We are committed to fulfilling our mission and vision, which is to save babies' lives and protect mothers and the unborn. And we're so grateful for God that God has called us to such an awesome, awesome mission. And as we enter into this year of faith, which Pope Benedict Emeritus has declared for the year 2013, we are committed to also help our mothers not only choose life for their babies, but also grow in their faith. Our banquet theme this year is Faith is the Realization of What is Hoped For and Things Not Yet Seen. This is not just the theme of our banquet. This is the theme of St. Gerard's. This is the theme that we live. And saving lives is not just about us having faith and praying and being a witness in front of the abortion clinic. It's also the grace that's given to those mothers while we pray for them as they consider abortion or going inside the clinic. And we saw a profound example of that last week. One of our volunteers, her name is Betty Wormald. She's here today. I asked her to please come up. She reached out in love to this woman going inside the abortion clinic last Saturday. But what Betty didn't know was that this woman was in great despair. She had one child. She was so fearful of having another baby. She was living in this place where she knows that she has to move out. She only has so much time and she has to leave. So she was so realizing that the only choice for her seemed like abortion. But when Betty reached out to her in love, she gave her the information about St. Gerard's and told her, "There's nothing you have to worry about. We will help you with everything." And when that girl walked into the abortion clinic, she, despite being in despair, then became hopeful because she started to ask questions like, "This St. Gerard's, what could they really do for me? How could this St. Gerard's really help me? Maybe they could help me." And that, through the grace of God, helped her to walk out and choose life for her baby. And so we were so thrilled when Betty came over to us. No, it's awesome. Betty came over to the center and she had given me that girl's number. And she said, "This girl, I don't know if she's still inside, please call her." I called her about 20 times. I just kept calling and calling and calling. And amazingly, she answered the phone and she said to me, "You know, I walked out of the abortion clinic and I am really struggling." And I said, "You have done the right thing and we're going to do everything we can to help you." And so this past Wednesday, she came to St. Gerard's and it was just really great as we talked more about, you know, her choosing life. You know, she said to me, "You know what? I never thought a program like this could exist. I never thought that people would be willing to help me like this." And so it was just an awesome, awesome moment. And she's gonna be coming to us for an ultrasound. So we're so, so thrilled. And the faith that we have really, really makes a difference. We are greatly committed and devoted to the divine mercy. And about a month or two ago, when I was out there praying, I just asked God before praying the chapel, I said, "Lord, I just pray that, you know, a mother will choose life. Please give a mother grace to do that." And when I was on the second decade of the chaplet, there were two young women, they're actually in the front seat here, that were coming toward the abortion clinic. And Marie, you wanna come up now? And Jocelyna? Now, Marie was 8 months pregnant, 9 months pregnant. Come on. And she was, of course, with her friend Jocelyna. So, of course, I knew Marie wasn't going for an abortion. And Jocelyna was with her. And I asked Marie to help me ask Jocelyna, "Why are you here today?" And Jocelyna said that she felt very alone. She felt very isolated. And I said, "That's exactly what St. Gerard's is all about. We are going to be your support. We are here for you. We'll help with everything you need." And they are very, very good friends. They're both Portuguese. They grew up in the same area. And I said, "Your baby and your children will be growing up together." And so I invited them to come to St. Gerard's. And we talked through things. And one of the things that Jocelyna was very worried about was that she didn't have any health insurance. And she was illegal. And so she was worried that she was not going to have the prenatal care that she needed for her baby. And so I told her that we would help her to get that. And through the grace of God, she has received the prenatal care. She also, that was a Friday when I met them. And the next day, she came for an ultrasound. And I tell you, it was so powerful to see how despairful Jocelyna was on Friday and how joyful she became on Saturday when she saw her precious baby in the womb. The baby, 16 weeks in the womb, leaping and jumping and waving. They even write on the ultrasound sometimes, "Hi, Mom." But one of the comments by our nurse, Marlene Gruden, she said that the joy that she saw in Jocelyna in seeing her baby in the womb was just awesome. And so she is one of our mothers, of course, that chose life. And it's really, really, as you can see, the total, total grace of God. This is Marie's little boy here. But this is essentially what we're about. And we're so blessed because now we've been doing ultrasound services for more than 2 years. With the grace of God, we have had 80 patients, and through also God's grace, more than 40 babies' lives have been saved, which otherwise would have died from abortion, just by them seeing that baby in the womb, and of course, the power of God's grace in changing their heart. One thing that we know, which is certain about abortion, is that abortion severs a mother's internal instincts. It brings a division against the woman and the child. But what's so powerful about the ultrasound services is that it reunites that mom with her baby. She's able to see that it's her baby. It's not just the baby, it's her baby, it's her own precious child. And we've witnessed that time and time again in doing our services. So we're so grateful to God for being able to provide that awesome gift of ultrasounds. We also have a second location. Our program is on Eaton Street, our 59 Eaton Street. And it's not just enough to save the baby's lives. These mothers need our help. They need help with a place to live. They need help with rent. They need help with bills. You know, we can't just say, oh, great job, have a baby, have a good life. No, we've got to sustain those lives. It's not just enough to help them choose life. That life has to be sustained because the life is sacred. And that's the essential part of what we're doing. Many, many programs, pregnancy centers, are becoming medical clinics, but they're not offering the supports that the girls need to have the baby. Yes, you can show the baby in the womb, but that's not enough. The girls must have that support. And that's essentially what we're doing. Literally, for many of the girls, sometimes we pay their rent all the way through the 9 months and beyond, just to give them so that they know that they have that foundation to turn to. We also are strongly at St. Gerard's promoting the message of chastity. This is key to our work. Absolutely essential, because we're speaking to the dignity of women and the dignity of motherhood. And that, as Jim Vaisovich so eloquently said, is being attacked today by the media, by this evil culture. So we have to fight that. We have to impart that message to these girls, to love themselves, to respect themselves. And so we are speaking out against all forms of birth control. All forms of birth control, and of course, against abortion. And especially now, when somebody as a minor can go and get an abortifacient, a morning after pill, over the counter without any parental rights, any parental permission, or any prescription. So we have to fight this. And this is it's so important to our work right now, because we're really taking charge of that. We have to educate the girls. It's so important that they know that. We have girls who, of course, once they have their babies, they're at Hartford Hospital, and the first thing that they will talk to them about is what type of birth control are you going to use? That's the first question. What type of birth control are you going to use after you have this baby? So we have to get these to these girls. On Friday, I was at the hospital, and the doctor talked to the girl about tying her tubes. And I told her, please, I said, God may be calling you to have another child. Please do not do that. And she decided not to tie her tubes after getting that message on Friday, praise God. We're also at St. Gerard's, as I said, we're committed to this message of the dignity of women, but we also care deeply about the girls' spirituality. We want them that in the event St. Gerard's would go away, these girls would always have faith, the importance of faith, because where Jesus Christ is in the heart of these women, abortion becomes an unthinkable reality. And that's what we want. We all know that these women, they know it's a baby, women that are considering abortion. But that's not the issue. People are aborting babies because of an inconvenience, because they don't want a second child. I hear that all the time. But if we help our girls know and love Jesus Christ, then abortion will never be a reality for them. And that's such an essential part of our message. We now have a deacon from the Archdiocese of Hartford. He comes to our center, and he's helping any of these moms prepare to have their children baptized. Christina Berger, who helped coordinate this banquet, she also does baptism preparation for the girls. And thus far, we have had more than 50 children become baptized as Catholics. And some of the mothers already also are coming into the Catholic Church because they're hungry for the truth. And that's exactly what we are giving them. We also help any mom who would like to place her child for adoption. I do get lots of calls about that. I myself am a birth mother. I placed a baby for adoption. I'm a strong promoter of adoption. And I will walk through any mom who would like to do that, make that decision. We've had several girls do that. Not too long ago, we had a mother place a baby with parents that only could have one child. And it was a beautiful, beautiful gift. I mean, the family was so happy, the mother was so happy, it was awesome. And finally, we also help any girls who have had abortions. When I mentioned that I was at the hospital on Friday, this woman, in tears, told me about two abortions that she had had. And she said she hardly ever talked to anybody about it. And she was in such despondency about talking about the abortion. I said, please, let's pray the Chaplet of Divine Mercy. And she begged God for mercy. She just begged God right at that moment, please forgive me. Please, you know, have mercy on me. And it was just a very powerful moment to just be there with her and see the contrition and also just see God's grace. That's what's so powerful about this work, seeing the grace of God convert people, convert these women right on the spot, going from contrition, going from a position of death to one of life, to one of recognizing the value of life. And this is what we're all about at St. Gerard's. And so I just want to thank you for your love and your support, and continue to pray for us, because we know the only way the scourge of abortion will ever come to an end is truly through the power of Jesus Christ and the Blessed Virgin Mary. God bless you, and I thank you.